Well, it's time. It's time to talk about the burpee. Here I am, disheveled, scrubby. My makeup person's out of town. Svelte, my hair guy, couldn't take me in today. So I'm presented to you raw, because I'm frustrated and I didn't have time to get ready for this. I'm frustrated by how the fitness world is defining burpees and explaining burpees. And once again, I came across yet another video, how to do burpees, where they actually used the word flop. Flop several times to describe how to do burpees. Now, if you have a trainer or a coach who uses the word flop when teaching you a new exercise in any sort of exercise description, it may be time to consider another choice of trainers or coaches. A flop is a fall gone wrong. A flop is a drop with far less accuracy. A flop is having no awareness, presence, or respect for your body or the movement. In fact, the burpee is a beautiful opportunity to get better at several things. This wonderful checklist here is all the things that you might get better at when doing a burpee. The first one is falling, properly falling. Falling is a skill. In this case, landing from a jump, if you choose to add the jump. And as we're gonna see a little later, this is practically forgotten. We're so geared on jumping up onto things, we forget how to come off of things. The skill of landing, the skill of falling, the skill of absorbing force is very important. And a burpee is a prime opportunity in doing it correctly. Second is an increase in athleticism. What this means is the ability to change from one motion to another motion, from one shape to another shape. That's where athleticism lies, is the transformation of the body from one shape to another shape. In this case, we have what we call the squatty shape into a planky shape, two of the most important shapes of all movement. And the burpee is a wonderful chance to master this transformation, to get better at actual athleticism. Nowhere in athleticism does flop come into play. Also, we have the understanding of these two shapes and actually moving from these two shapes, which is the next on the list, being able to do a better squat and a better plank or even a push-up. You have the two things built into a burpee. You have a chance to squat and a chance to do a plank or a push-up. And what we tend to do is we flop and then squirm to get back up. What we can do is actually squat into a plank or a push-up back to your squat to come up, whether it's a jump or not. We also have an amazing chance to be aware of our body more. As we should with any movement, a burpee allows us the prime chance to be aware of our hips and our shoulders, the bookends of our spine that are so important for all of movement. If we can find our shoulders, which means turning on our lats, big muscle the lats, if we can find our hips, which means turning on our booty, big muscle the ass, if we can find our ass and our lats, we have a greater awareness of movement as a whole. And here's another opportunity to do that. And again, flopping doesn't give us that chance. And I'm sure we can add to this list, but the point is, when done right, we have a chance to increase our awareness, our empowerment as a human. If we're just, well, flopping into a movement, we're not learning anything. We're not actually getting better at anything except for that flopping. As we've often quoted Tommy Kono as saying, practice makes permanent. If we're flopping over and over again for high repetitions, what are we making permanent? What are we actually getting good at besides the art of exhausting ourselves? It's thanks to the recent trend of turning workouts into sport, workouts into competition, the whole sport of working out, where now we feel that everything has to be done faster for more reps. It's all about do more faster rather than do better. Now, in any other sport, and this is important, in any other sport beyond the sport of fitness, we know that doing things better first will allow us to do it faster, better, if that makes sense. If you've practiced any other sport or any other art form, you know that doing things slow and mastering the movement, mastering the idea, embodying the actual process makes you a better athlete or artist. Then you can do it faster. In fact, this whole new sport of working out is the only sport that allows us to get sloppier to try to get faster. That encourages floppy as part of the sport. In any other sport, if you start to get sloppy in your movements, you're either pulled out of the game or you're going to lose. If you actually do these movements properly, you can then make them faster. I'm going to show you how you can actually do a faster burpee by doing it better. I know, it's crazy. Who would possibly think that that would be the case? Aren't you just supposed to flop into it? We're not here to talk creative burpees today. I feel like we've done that quite a bit. We've even addressed the basic foundations of a burpee, but I feel like we need to do it again. It's getting a little overwhelming, seeing it done so horribly performed and taught wrong, just taught poorly. Now, there is a history of a burpee. The burpee originally wasn't really meant to be an exercise as much as it was an assessment. It was a test for basic level of fitness. But this was 70, 80 years ago, and since then, it should have evolved into something better. Because as we do, we take an assessment, we're great at this, we take an assessment, turn it into an exercise, we've done this time and time again, and what seems to have happened is we've turned it into something even worse. Even worse than what it was. Back when it was an assessment, it wasn't the best of assessments because frankly back then we didn't seem to care so much about, spine or posture like we do now. But now it's gotten even more disastrous to the spine, dangerous for the body, and just simply ugly. We can evolve beyond it. So instead of the original bend over, kick your feet out, which is what it was called a squat thrust, even though there really was no squat. You bent over, you kicked your feet out, came back up, no jump or anything. Then we decided, hey, let's add a push-up and a jump. And that's cool, that's groovy, except now it's no longer a push-up and a jump. It's a flop and a squirm. It's like some of the worst yoga I've ever seen. And we can do better. And so let's turn it into something that's actually beneficial for us. Here's Ninja Kyle to show us how to properly land. Or from a little lower. And from the ground. And now, Kyle, show us how not to land. Allison, show us what a good burpee could look like. Or with a clap. So Allison actually had to practice a bad burpee to be able to film this today. It's just not in her body to do it wrong. Because practice makes permanent, and guess how she's been practicing. All right, look, here's a shining example of how doing something better is going to make you faster. Remember, we're trying to avoid the flop. We're not trying to just to the ground and squirm our way back up. We can drop to the ground if it's under control and we keep that plank shape. Even if we go all the way to the ground, we're going to come up with a plank shape. We're not going to squirm our way up. That's very important. Now, I know some friends of mine are going to write me and say, hey, what about the sprawl burpee? We do sprawl burpees in martial arts. Yes, yes, you do. And they're appropriate for martial arts training. They're not a flop. They're actually a controlled fall into the sprawl position. That's cool. You and I will do some together in the future. It's going to be a good time. This is more of a classic, traditional, standard burpee that you see in most gyms. If I come up from a regular burpee, I'm down here, and I come up like that. That's the slow motion version of how people come up from a burpee. That's multiple parts put together. If I have the strength If I've worked on building the proper strength to be able to do this, remember, that's what transfers to other skills. Otherwise, if you don't have transfer to other skills, why are you doing this? I can pop up much quicker. Watch how much faster this is. Two parts, into the squat jump, rather than three parts. So if you have that power to be able to pop up off the ground athletically, then it's gonna be much faster anyway. So let's work on getting down there and up with that plank shape from the squat to the plank. If you think you can actually drop to the ground faster than pulling yourself down in a squat, then you can go ahead and try that. But if you've dabbled at all in Olympic weightlifting, you know you can pull yourself down into a squat really quickly. So if I can land in that nice soft squat for my jump up, land in that nice squat, I can get down there and out very quickly. But if I still believe I'm gonna drop faster, that's fine, just drop in that beautiful plank position. Drop yourself down into that plank so you can come up quicker. That's much quicker than this. Do it right, better, you'll get faster. Clap or no clap, it doesn't really matter, you're still gonna be quicker. Sirens, the bane of outdoor filming. In fact, hi, Mr. Pro.
I'm working now.